Hello everyone, welcome back to this Let's Play of Might and Magic 7 for Blood and Honor, where we are playing with a dark side party. In the last episode, we promoted over half of our party actually. It's only Jenniki right now that's not promoted, and who is not the weakest member in our party, I guess, but certainly growing less and less useful every single episode. And that's not going to change anytime soon. Max is a lich, so bye-bye, Mr. Goblin Man. Emmanuel is a priest of dark. Jenniki, yeah. Still normal little Jenniki. Oh, we found a cloak, apparently. And Penny is a ninja. Something we kind of cheated ourselves into, to be quite honest with you. But that's fine. Why doesn't my mouse work right now? It does. Okay, good. Let's just see here. I think we're just gonna sell actually our Sublime Spear, even though it served us well. Her hand-to-hand prowess is now much better than her staff fighting will, or spear fighting will ever be, so that's fine. Let's see, she probably... Oh, he actually has the highest armor class. Well, yeah, he's pretty much packed with armor. Okay, in this episode, we have a lot of possibilities. I think I talked about in the last episode... Wait, I'm gonna have to actually look at the time. So I'm not going overboard again with time, with my recording session. Let's see here. Well, we are in the Telerian Forest. Are we just going to raid the Elven Treasury and just, you know, get it over with? That's a distinct possibility. I mean, why not? We need to sooner or later complete a breeding zone. I mean, we are a lich now. Can't we just... Grandmastering air magic will make that slightly easier. Slightly. Not a lot, actually. We could do the... Oh yeah, I wanted to learn how to do the town portal thing, didn't I? Yeah. And kill all the griffins. Apparently we missed somebody in Bracada. And then win Aquamage in all 13 taverns. And we have 11. And, you know, that means we miss one, as far as I remember. So that's pretty much sucky. What we could do... I think we actually were going to go for the raid the Castle Navan treasury, because it's so ridiculously easy. And it's a castle that I haven't really raided before. So, not completely. And by that I mean I haven't completely destroyed everyone inside of the castle before. And, you know, we're playing a dark, evil party. So you might as well do that. Oh yeah, Lady Carmen's dagger is always with us. We don't need that. We're already an assassin, so let's just put that here in Telerian Forest. We don't need it. Or is that actually a better dagger than what we're using right now? That's actually a possibility because of the 5 points of body damage. It is, actually. Okay, never mind. We're actually going to use Lady Carmen's dagger. I've never done that before. Never. Normally, because if you remember with Lucky as well, I normally just go pure staff fighting with sorcerers, because I think that looks better. And we will do that with Max too if we ever find that artifact or relic I've been talking about, which is like the best relic in the game. No, not really. But it's really, really good for druids, clerics, and liches. And it looks super cool with a lich. But yeah, I think we're just gonna enter Castle Haven here, and because we're evil party, they're actually unfriendly with us. We are gonna refrain from killing peasants, because we don't really want to have any more... Yeah, I know. Halt! Visitors aren't permitted in this section of the castle. If you're looking for King Parson's throne room, take the lift down and follow the lift corridor.
Tis but a scratch.
Screw that.
Tis but a scratch.
We're gonna kill the guards, definitely. Or the guards are gonna kill us, apparently. Max, why? We're gonna try to avoid killing the peasants, because we don't really need more, bounty on us. So let's see here, we're just gonna pick up everything here with Penny, we don't really care. I don't think Penny has had any kind of, like, Oh, wait, hello. You need to die. I'm sorry, but you're a guard. And those two are just peasants, not gonna kill them. So in here a unique character, and those are those
I don't know.
Oh, you still don't know? Elven scouts. Female elven archers shooting at you. They are gigantic. You'll see that they're so much taller than the rest of the elves in here. Actually, I think I showed you guys that before. But it's still so weird to me. It just doesn't make any sense. And they have literally no hit points, and they're just pathetic, and it's no problem here at all. No, now, normally what you're supposed to do here, raiding the Elven Treasury, what you can do then is just going invisible. Because, you know, you don't really need to kill all of these people. There's definitely no point in doing that. I'm not even bothering picking up the bodies. I guess maybe... So maybe we're gonna pick up the Elven Archers here just in case, but... You know, normally I've never actually seen them drop bows before, so... And besides, I'm not really sure if there's gonna be any good bows at this point. This castle also has the unique property of leading to another dungeon. The Tularian Caves that we've been talking about before that we haven't been in any of my Let's Plays. So I was actually thinking that maybe we should be kind enough to you guys to actually go into... the Tularian Caves as well and just clear it out on our way out and see where we would normally rescue Lauren Steele. So, you know, we've been here before, and this road leads to King Parson's room, which will now be locked because, you know, we're kind of killing all of his warriors and stuff.
Ow!
Yeah, but as you might hear, there are actually dragonflies in this castle, in one room specifically. It's kind of weird. I don't really think they ever give a good explanation for it, but... Where those dragonflies are. That's where there is something leading to the Tularian Caves. The treasures in here sucks big time. There's no point in picking them up. So we're just gonna ignore them. I think it's down here that this road here leads to the Tularian Caves. Yep, here are dragonflies. Good old friendly dragonflies.
Ow!
Just to make sure. Oh, hello. Ah, we can probably get out from the other way here. Yeah, that's actually true. I was just thinking maybe there's also like a secret key here that we have to open up this treasure chest in order to get some kind of key or something. Nope. Okay. Never mind. We're not even gonna bother picking up the money here. I know that we can get from the Tularian Caves to Castle Navan, though, so I know it's possible. But what's the point in doing it, actually? I don't know. Severely diminishing the amount of female elves in this castle. That's fine. But if you want to do the cheap trick of getting promoted to a Black Knight, then you just need to... Oh, come on. Then you need to go over here with invisibility, basically. And... I don't remember exactly where, but this floor somewhere has a... Oops, we killed a peasant. That was not what I meant to do, Penny. You knew that. I told you already. But that's fine. A large-ass library that I don't think features any scrolls or any good scrolls at all. Yeah, actually, with Wizard Eye right now, you can already see the... I'm just gonna check out what kind of scrolls this king actually has. You can already see the treasury, or you could, until I move too far away from it. It'll show up now again. That's the treasury, the large round thing there. And, you know, the Frederick Org, or whatever his name, the guy who told us to do this, basically, he said that, you know, oh, this treasury is so great, and there are very few treasures like it in all of the land, and it's just not true at all. Ooh, Dragon Breath, we're going to learn that eventually. Kind of cool to use that already, just to see the power of it. Hello, are you unfriendly? Yes, you are. Sucks to be you. Hey, Max, we're never going to use Dragon Breath because of the... Oh, that was crappy. I mean, once you get become super good at dark magic, that can do hundreds worth of damage, and that's pretty sick. Probably one of the best spells in the game, if you don't count Shrap Metal in terms of pure damage. But again, we're just gonna stick with Shrap Metal once that day comes. And that's not so far away. I mean, we're Liches now, so... We're Liches and a Priest of Dark, so we can learn dark magic Grandmaster once we just level up a bit more, which will happen, so... But yeah, basically here, right, peasant? Have you, by the way, noticed how incredibly powerful those asses on both male and female elf peasants in this game look? It's insane. But yeah, this is basically a treasury, and you don't, as far as I remember, you don't even need to go down or do open any chests or anything. You just need to get down here and be like, hey guys, and that's it. But there is a lot of money here, though. Or not a lot, but we do need money right now. But again, I'm sorry to say it, but, like, look at this. Rogue's plate armor. How no?
Pure
steel gauntlets, no enchantments. How about no? There's just no point. The only, like, semi-good thing you can get here... Ooh, we did actually find a bow here, didn't we? There we go, an ordinary longbow. That's why you don't pick up these bodies. We do have those barrels there. If you have a thief, then of course go ahead and make sure that you check these treasure chests, but... I don't want to die, so we're not going to check these treasure chests, but I promise you they don't really contain anything good at all. Well, you know what? Since we're already here, why not? I know, I'm so nice. But I mean, I forgot that I had maxed up a lot of potential or skill points in Max's, meditation skill, so that's why. Ugh, so many treasure chests, though. I can promise you that this will not be worth it, and when I say that, it probably means that it will be worth it, just you
Let's
wait.
Leave it behind.
I'll probably find something in here I can use, and I just know I'm gonna regret not doing this, so that's why I'm basically doing it. Yeah, definitely next party I'm gonna have to thief again so I can actually pick traps. Here we go, look at this crap, but fine, we're gonna pick up the money. As far as I remember, some chests in here were better than the others. Once again, it's been a long time since I played a dark party, though. I mean, this is a great elven treasure, a dagger, a crude dagger found in the hands of thieves and ruffians. English is hard. Everywhere.
Let's leave it behind.
A pearl ring with an imperfect pearl. This is the treasure that Frederick Org wants us to steal in order to become Black Knights, because this is so, so amazingly good, huh? Your lie, mister! It actually wouldn't surprise me if Penny could have opened up these chests on her own. And the bad thing is that, okay, we killed a peasant right now and we killed a couple of guards. That probably means that we have to pay some kind of bounty or fine in one of the town halls. Hello, by the way. Last thing I'm gonna check, I'm just gonna make sure that I actually remove all of the guards in here. I mean, come on. Do not leave anyone alive. If you fall down from the lift, you'll be taken to this room over here. That's why there's like a corridor down here. And I don't think there'll be anything but peasants here. Okay, there's actually nothing here. Then, never mind. I know there's a scared peasant in the elevator itself, and I'm sorry about that, but it'll be fine so far. What do you think about this, Victor the Instructor? Or you, fake Lauren? Still so random to have a fake Lauren with me here. Let's see here. Yep, three peasants totally panicking, and that's it. And that was totally a text message, and I'm sorry about that. Nope. Dumba. So let's see here. I always forget to turn off my phone or something before I start these Let's Plays, because I always think, who's gonna send me a message now? And then it always happens. Maybe, that's like a plan. If you're feeling lonely or if you want some friends or something, then start doing Let's Plays, because I promise you, your Skype and your cell phone will both buzz quite a lot and annoy the hell out of you when you don't need it to. So, yeah. We just also gotta think now about... we're just gonna check the town hall here. If we have to pay any
the
fines. Yes,
session.
Only 2,600. That's fine. A master... Nope, nowhere close.
Your gold is safe. Your gold is safe with us.
Totally forgot
you
about.
You got no money here.
Yes, I did. I just withdrew 10,000. You idiot. I just thought about that. We have to be careful about where, you know, we can become grandmaster with different spells right now. This is mind magic grandmaster, right? No, this is spirit. Then fine. Our first grandmaster is Emmanuel, who learns Grandmaster Spirit Magic from Benjamin the Balanced. With great Grandmaster Spirit Magic, you can learn all of the Grandmaster spells for this devotion. Higher level spells may prove more potent and of greater assistance to your party. That means now that Bless and Heroism will last way much longer, which is really, really nice. And also that Raise Dead will function whenever. Okay, actually, Race Dead has a really long... it doesn't really matter if you Grandmaster or Master that. Oh yeah, we can fly. I keep forgetting that. I just don't think there's any other Grandmaster teachers here that we actually need help from. Is there? I don't think so. Let's just first of all go here and
how
be like...
How may we help you? Walk in the light.
Not sure what they just cast on us, but we'll take it. Oh, preservation. That's fine. We're not going to need it, though. I mean, in the Tellarian Caves where we are going right now, just once again to show you guys what the Tellarian Caves are all about, considering I didn't go there in my first Let's Play, I guess we also have to do Fort River Stride, just to show you, basically, what it's all about. We will rock you. No, we will encounter Wyverns, and we have to battle some of those Wyverns, and if we face... Ancient Wyvern, then we can insta-kill or insta-die. Oh yeah, right, it's the fighting here. How did that go? Hello. They won't even talk to us, but they basically killed all of the elves, didn't they? There's way more humans here than there were elves. So let's see here, the Tellarian Caves. Fresh human or elvish footprints lead into this cave, and weeds and brush have been cleared from the entrance recently. And here we go.
Okay, let's go in.
Immediately with the Wyverns. What we're basically going to do here is to try to set or give back the fake Lauren. We don't want him. Okay, we found gauntlets.
Pure garbage.
Yeah, they are. So, what's kind of unique about this dungeon is that you all the way in the beginning here can have like four possibilities of where to go. You can fall down, you can go to the right down there, you can go straight ahead, and you can go to the left. I'm not actually sure where you're supposed to go, but we'll just go. There's also another thing here. Usually when you are there first time, you won't have learned telekinesis, and there is one treasure chest that you have to have telekinesis to actually open. Again, the treasures here right now are sucky big time, so we're not going to bother picking them up. I'm sorry about that if that was something you looked forward to, but I just don't see the point. What's kind of unique about this place as well is that it features some traps, like this one, where you like, you'll get pushed down there if you aren't quick enough to pass it. It's kind of interesting. It's just basically a bunch of caves connected naturally that the elves have used for a defensive outpost, and it's kind of interesting. It's an interesting idea, definitely. Yeah, they're not too good for... or they're not that dangerous right now, though. So there's three kinds of monsters in here, if I remember correctly. There's troglodytes, like we face in the Whitecliff Caves, the creepy ones without an eye that I still find kind of scary. There is... Wyverns, as we already face, and they're just elven lancers or elven spearmen. So if we get hit by one of these things, then we will get teleported downstairs. They won't literally push us off, they will just teleport us off, because, you know, the game isn't really that complex enough to handle that, I guess. Yes, is this the entrance to Castle Navan? It is. So now we can finally check out how that actually works. Yeah, you have... I'm guessing that we have to come from this way and open up the secret entrance door here. Of course, the thing is, like... Oh, crap. I just... Okay, that was actually kind of clever. Now we have to go all the way back. Sorry. Again, like, when you first enter here, then, through that door... then everybody will be pissed off at you. Everybody will start attacking you, and that's not cool. That's really, really bad. So, I don't recommend going that way. And it's, you know, super easy to mix it up. Like, when you're going there the first time, you're just suddenly pissing off the entire Elven Castle. It doesn't really make sense that developers added it that way, but it did. I have no good explanation for it. Da, 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 da. Sorry. That slightly hurt. I'll never be a good singer, that's for sure. But it won't stop me from singing, though, because I enjoy singing. It makes me Oh, crapo. Okay, good thing that you dodged that, Francesca the Tinker. You like to tinkle? Let's get out of here, because there's, like, peasants in the way. Oh, crap. Not flying into the walls or the rooftops of the house. That's not nice. Let's see here. We're just going to skip over the mountains. Skip a doodle doo. Do 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 do. Skip a doodle. At one point, it actually kind of tempts to kill these humans here just for killing all of these elves. I mean, when I was young, I used to support the elves, actually, in the elf-human war. I just found that more interesting. I guess that's because I used to roleplay my parties more, and I usually had some elven princes or something in my party. Is it up there that treasure chest is? Yes, it is. That treasure chest up there, you can't reach by any normal means. But, like, it's so crappy. I'm not really sure why they added it at all. If it's just to tease you or something, I don't know. The troglodytes and the wyverns are natural enemies in this cave for some reason, as are the wyverns and elves. The troglodytes and elves hardly ever meet each other, but I'm gonna assume that they also are enemies. Yeah, one thing that's strange here is that, like, you might think that you can't get over here. You are in one of the earlier treasure chests. I think you will find a scroll that will tell you that you can just... There's an invisible bridge here, basically. So you can just pass it without any problems whatsoever. So yeah, we're not doing this entirely right, as we're supposed to. Apparently this used to be some kind of thieves' hideout, I think. So that's the explanation given. I think it's kind of weird, but I'll take it. The reason to go here is to push that lever in the wall down. That is a necessary thing to do. Oh, this is actually the right way to go. Oh, let's help the wyverns. You won! Congratulations! Okay, you didn't win after all. Okay, we've been lucky so far, though. Not even a horned wyvern. Only wyverns and troglodytes, like ordinary troglodytes. Because if we had faced an ancient wyvern in here, it could have decimated my entire party. I've had that happen before. They can take down all of you in just a moment of seconds, because one hit can mean one KO. Or one death, actually. Not even a KO, but like insta-death.
That wasn't hard.
That's why I cast Protection for Magic, is because Horned Wyverns, of course, can disease you. Troglodytes can poison you. I just wanted to make sure that I avoided that for... Hey, look! They actually killed two Wyverns in here! That's so nice! Congratulations! I didn't expect that.
This might be of use to us.
Nope, I'm not even gonna bother with the treasure chest. Maybe it's here that you find one of those scrolls that will, like, tell you... Just walk straight ahead and you'll be fine, even if it seems like there's nothing there. Yeah, that's the reason why I actually started picking up wyverns, because ancient wyverns can drop really nice things, and actually troglodyte queens can drop really nice things. I've had it happen before. So if you find a troglodyte queen or an ancient wyvern, pick up their bodies, because they can be nice, and this was like a no-go. That was like a dead end, so sorry about that. Let's see here. We haven't been... This is the bottom part. If you just fall down from the start, the entrance is like... If you look at the map right now, it's like straight ahead. And we need to get back to the start because we pretty much finished everything except for... We're just going to make sure that we finished absolutely everything also in the beginning here, where we eventually entered the way to Castle Navan, the secret little spot thingy place. Have you been here?
Oh, hello. Oh, please.
Yeah, Jenniki, you're supposed to be nice to your fellow elves. Yeah, there's a treasure chest. This is like how you really should see the treasure chest. I'm actually going to try something I haven't tried before. I just knew that on the non-GOG version, there is a possibility that you can climb the walls like that. It's like wall scaling almost. It's super easy. In my good Let's Play, I think I didn't play this GOG version. I installed a new one. Then I think I actually just played on a version that was installed from a CD, which is where I'm used to climbing, as you have seen. You know, just basically walking against a hill and you'll start walking up that hill. Another thing I'm very used to from that is the ability to, like, scale walls, that you can just basically be Spider-Man and just walk straight ahead in a really, really... Let's see, nope. Yeah, it will always open. Yeah, okay, so we've been pretty much everywhere right now. Okay, I guess I can show you guys what happens when we get hit by one of these things. If we get hit by one of these things. then you get teleported down here instead. I guess it is because the game mechanics didn't always work when it came to pushing you off. Maybe you clipped through it or something, I don't know, but I think it's quite a charming little addition that there's like traps here. It's one of the few dungeons to actually feature some kind of elaborate scheme in Might and Magic 7. As far as I remember, Might and Magic 6 had a lot more of them, and if I ever do a Let's Play of Might and Magic 6, which might happen, I'm not saying it will, but I'm saying it might, because that game is so long, it's like way long, and my life is now starting to become a bit more packed, as you might have noticed with my like uploading schedule or uploading rhythm. Or a schedule, it's starting to get kind of mixed up because, oh crap, that was not my intention. We're wasting so much time in here. How much time have we spent so far? Yep, we are basically going to use this entire... This can be a good item, by the way, since it was a troglodyte queen.
Trash, if I've ever
It wasn't, but it could have been. As far as I remember, it's just like the cobras in Might and Magic 6, if you play that. Like, cobras are one of the first enemies you meet in the first dungeon that you're supposed to go to. But they can... Especially the Cobra Queens can drop seriously nice accessories. They really can. I remember finding a cloak in like my first 30 minutes of playtime in Might and Magic 6 once that I wore until the end of the game. And I've also done that once with a pair of gauntlets in Might and Magic 7. So I know it's possible. It's just been, you know, it's been a while. If you remember over here, there were like three doors that we could enter. They all lead to different places. One of them leads back to the entrance, one leads back to... Hello, cloak? We're just gonna save, by the way. One leads back to the entrance, one leads back to this treasure area. And that's why I saved, because I didn't remember which was which. I think the one in the middle is the one that goes to the right place. Nope, it was the one to the left, so let's go back here and check where the middle one goes. Okay, yeah, that's to the entrance to Castle Navan. Okay, so nobody goes back to the exit. My mistake. But this one... No, wait, what? Why is it changing like this? Alright, no, it wasn't... Yeah, never mind. I'm just being stupid. There we go. This is the final portion of this dungeon. There are three, like... pillars here that move around, and the one on the right has a treasure chest on it. And there's always some fighting wyverns and troglodytes here. Once again, we've been very lucky not to have a single ancient wyvern here. There's no reason to pick up any treasure chests. They basically won't produce anything good. The levels of the items in here are super crappy. Okay, that's all the monsters. This row just leads back up to the teleporter that we need to go eventually. And when you're gonna rescue the real Lauren, if that's what you're gonna do in this dungeon, then the real Lauren will be in this cave up here for 1 month after getting the quest.
It's locked!
But of course,
it's locked.
Nobody's here now. He has been executed, and we have fake Lauren with us in our party still. Yeah, I'm not complaining about it, I'm just saying, if he uses food, extra food for traveling and stuff, I will murder Queen Catherine. No, wait, King Navan. Well, I kind of butchered this entire castle, so I guess I kind of already did that, didn't I? Sorry. And then, let's just go back to the exit. Boom, there we go. So this has been the Tolarian Caves, we finally got to do it. We will do also the... the Forged River Stride. Next time we're in Arafia, we're just gonna pop in there and be like, hello, we're gonna kill you. Because we kind of, you know, have to, just to show you guys what that dungeon is all about. That dungeon is shorter, but much more packed with enemies, and much more packed with dangerous traps. This one had just annoying traps. Forged River Stride has dangerous traps. It has seriously, seriously debilitating traps. So, look forward to that. What we're gonna do now, though, is while it's still before 6 p.m., we're gonna hurry up. Do we gonna go to Avli or do you wanna go to Deja? We don't wanna go to any of those, do we? Avli, I don't think there's anything we need to do there right now. Eventually there is, but not right now. And Deja? Nope, we just came from Deja, so we don't need to go to Deja. So we're gonna do what my party does best. We're gonna wait an entire day. Harmondale, kind of tempting, because then we can get to other places after that. And
welcome aboard.
Yep, Harmondale it is. Because from Harmondale we can get to the Bricka or Barrow Downs, and then we can get to Nyan, which is would just be a good thing to do right now. I think it would just be nice to. Oh right, I totally forgot about that. Now I know what we'll be not doing in the next episode. Yeah, I totally forgot to borrow the van from Mr. Malvik in the first episode. Totally forgot about that, so hello. My lords, I have a message for you from Niall Stantley, an associate of Mr. Malvik, whom I'm sure you've already met. I'd advise you read this message and act upon it with all due speed. Mr. Stantley does so admire punctuality. My lords, I request your presence at a mercenary guild in Italia in 2 weeks to discuss the service you owe an associate of mine, Mr. Malvik. Failure to adhere to this request could prove most devastating for you and your town. I look forward to meeting you. Niall Stantley. Yeah, I guess we need to get our asses to Arafia then. I want to try to do this quest for once. I've never done it before.
The coach leaves right away.
Boom, Tatalia. So we're just going to start this quest this episode. Oh yeah, the Bowman doesn't like us. Sorry. Actually, if I may, can I just check what is in... what kind of bounty the bounty hall town hall has right now? Bounty hall. Oh, and we can also, a lot of things we could do right now, actually. A giant bat. Well, that's not going to be worth it ever. I was just thinking, here, we can return to Frederick Org. And, alright! That robbery was brilliant. I'm very proud of you. Keep the loot. It's your reward for a job well done. I can safely say the cavaliers amongst you have become black knights today, and I'll throw in an honorary black title knight for the rest of you. Knight title for the rest of you. You've done well, my students. Yay! We're now unfriendly with the town. That means we can be placed in prison, I think. Yay!
Traveling today?
Whatever, let's
right
just
away.
Go to the... Nope, not Bricotta. Nope, 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 nope. We need to get there eventually, but not right now. We need to get to Tatalia first.
Right away.
I mean, we're playing an evil party. Why not try to actually do the quest that is given to us by this awful weirdo that we're going to meet right now? It's kind of tempting to actually give it a fair shot. I've never done that before. I normally just take the attack on Harmondale instead if I borrow the van from Mr. Malvik. But you know what? Damn it, we're going to steal some tapestry from Castle Gloaming, or at least try. We have invisibility, so... If I just remember where Grandmaster Air Magic is, then, we could totally Grandmaster that right now and have invisibility for a long time. So we're going to do that in the next episode. Or a try. We might fail, but I really want to give it a fair shot for once, because normally I don't. So hello, Mercenary Guild. What do you have to say to me now? Greetings, my friends. I've come to collect on a deal you made with my associate, Mr. Malvik. I trust you remember him from Emerald Isle. We request your services for one task. A rare and valuable tapestry rests in Castle Gloaming, an antique from near the Silence stolen from the Visage some time ago. I would like you to get the tapestry for me, as my normal associates don't have access to Castle Gloaming. In return, I'll make sure that the large band of renegade swordsmen and goblins near Harmondale don't accidentally stumble upon your quiet little village. You have 1 month. Don't be late. You don't have the tapestry yet, and the clock is ticking. It would be prudent to keep the task at hand rather than bothering me with your babble. I've never done this. Normally, I just say screw you and take the attack because the attack is pathetic. Normally, I don't lose any peasants because I managed to kill everybody else before they even touch my peasants. But you know what? We're going to give it a fair shot. So let's get to Deja. Do 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 do.
Welcome aboard.
Ugh, I hate it when this happens. I know we're gonna end this episode right now, but we're just gonna make sure that we are in the right place so I remember what to do. No, Penny, you're not the one who's supposed to be the merchant. Don't smile about that, because that was a crappy deal. You made a bad deal, Penny. Feel bad about yourselves. Yourself. Not yourselves.
Traveling today? The coach leaves right away.
And I'm just also gonna double check while I'm here. I know this just gets dragged on forever, this episode, and I'm sorry about that. I just want to check in the town here where I missed those griffins again. Was it Bracada or was it Arafia? I think it was Bracada, but I just want to make absolutely sure. Do, 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 do. Do, do, do. Of course, the bad thing about doing this quest is that everybody in Castle Gloaming will be mad at us. And we kind of don't want that. Let's see here. Yeah, Bracada Desert. That's fine. I'm sure there is one that ran away or something that we didn't quite catch. Or there's maybe one area with griffins that we didn't see. That's a distinct possibility. At least the ones in Arafia has been registered as defeated, and that's usually the one that gets bugged for me, so I'm kind of excited about that fact. Or not excited, but I'm happy about that fact. I can live with that. Let's instead get to the pity pity pit. I actually think we're gonna have to do one more thing though before we actually try to steal the tapestry. I think we're gonna try to do the breeding zone, or the breeding pits. The reason being that I'm afraid that all of the castle doors will lock once we steal the tapestry. Because we have to piss off people in order to get to the tapestry, as far as I remember. So we're gonna try to be a bit, smart here. So actually, next episode, we're just going to start the entire thing by trying to take on the breeding pit, which will be difficult, not going to lie. It's not my favorite quest in the world, but it needs to get done. So, I've been a Biting Gamer. Thank you for joining me.